Explorers, I'm just on my way inside with some fresh picked strawberries for Mia. She's been working hard in the lab all day.
Ah!
Oh no, that can't be good.
Mia, what happened?
I've made a terrible mistake. I didn't add my Antarctic phosphatase at the right time, and now the plasmid DNA that I was trying to clone religated.
Which means
my experiment is ruined.
That's okay. It's just a small mistake. You can always redo the experiment.
It took me 3 months to get to this point. And besides, you can't just make one little mistake. You have to follow the rules. Always. Otherwise, you could get seriously hurt. Or at the very least have a lot of hard work go to waste.
That's right. There are rules for everything.
Stop! We're breaking another rule right now. We can't eat in the lab.
That could have been dangerous. We don't know what chemicals could be left on the lab bench.
Or on my gloves.
I'm gonna get these out of here.
Rules rule in the kingdom of science. There are standard sets of rules in the lab. The first set of rules help keep us safe. For example, there should be no running, roughhousing, or horseplay. Doing so could result in cuts, bumps, or even burns. One important safety rule in the lab is to always wear your safety glasses. Another rule is to make sure that hair and jewelry stay out of the way. This means tying back long hair, removing bracelets, and tucking in necklaces. And last but not least, remember to put on your gloves. An important safety rule is to pay attention to what you're doing. Don't leave your equipment unattended and read chemical labels carefully. Try to label what you have, or at the very least, don't mix up your containers. There are lots of chemicals that look similar, but do very different things. Take these three beakers, for example. These are all clear liquids. One is water, which is safe to drink. One is ethanol, which we use to clean the lab. If you drink this, you could get very sick. And one contains polyacrylamide. It looks just like water before it sets into a gel. But it's a dangerous neurotoxin and must be handled with care. Now, can you tell which is which? The second set of lab rules is about respect. Many people will be working in the lab at the same time, and when they do, messes, and therefore mistakes, can occur quickly. That's why we need to take care of the lab and keep it clean for everyone. Once we're done, we can wipe up any spills, dispose of our chemicals properly, and we can clean all our lab equipment. This way, the lab stays clean for everyone, especially if your lab is also your kitchen and you live at home with your parents. They'll appreciate the cleanliness, and they might even let you do cooler and messier experiments in the future. So we went over rules for safety and rules of respect in the lab. We still have to go over rules of fun, but I'll need to join up with Taya for that later. Hey, where is Taya?
The lab isn't the only place that has rules. When you're out in nature, there's rules we need to follow so that we're kind to creation and don't get hurt. Just like the safety rules for the lab, you shouldn't horse around in areas that have real dangers. Slippery rocks, large boulders, and steep hills are all areas where injuries can occur, which might make it difficult to explore further. You should also dress for the weather and the location.
If you're out in the snow, you can't go wrong if you bundle up. If it's rainy, make sure you have boots and a raincoat. If it's hot and sunny, make sure you've loaded up on sunscreen, bring a bottle of water, and take your sun hat and sunglasses with you.
And if you're walking in the woods, make sure your arms and legs are covered. That way, it reduces the chance that you could pick up ticks. And you can never have too much bug spray. And when you're venturing out into the woods, make sure you stay on marked trails or sidewalks. If you don't, you could wander into habitats of animals or plants that don't like to be disturbed. Worst of all, you could get lost. That's why it's important to have an adventuring friend or family member with you.
Whether it's birds, bugs, balloons, or the bazaar, God's creation is beautiful and exciting, and it should always be respected. That's why we have rules for respecting nature. Try to identify plants and animals before picking them up or touching them to make sure it's safe to do so. Not only will it keep you and God's creation safe, but you'll also be able to learn a lot more. If you can't identify something, it's best you leave it alone. And make sure to pick up any trash so animals don't mistake it for food. As a general rule of respect, you should only take pictures and leave only footprints.
Now that we've discussed rules that help keep us and others safe during our explorations, let's talk about some rules that keep things fun and easy. Now, the easiest way to do this in the lab is to keep a lab notebook. A lab notebook contains all the important things that you need to make sure your experiments are running smoothly. Now, I know it can take a little bit of time to get it started and keep it going, but I promise you, it's the most important thing you can do to have fun while conducting your experiments, and it can help you learn a lot, including where you might have gone wrong.
Like how you were able to learn where you went wrong in your experiment earlier.
Don't remind me.
You can also do something similar with the outdoors by keeping an adventure journal. In it, you can write, draw, and collect your findings.
Whether you're indoors or outdoors, keeping a notebook or a journal is a great way to share your adventures, experiments, and investigations with others. And it'll help you grow as an Orthodox explorer.
But now we have more exciting things to talk about, like church.
Oh no, are we gonna be late?
No, we're not gonna be late. But church has its own set of rules, and we need to go over them before we leave.
That's right. Just like we explore different scientific topics, we also need to explore our faith. And just like science, exploring Orthodoxy is full of so much excitement and a set of rules.
First, we need to talk about safety rules. We should not play around in church. There's so many different things going on, and we need to be vigilant. You could trip and fall. You could accidentally bump into the priest and hurt them, not to mention all the candles that could be knocked over or the icons that could be damaged.
We should try to stay still and away from burning candles, unless you're specifically instructed to hold one.
Even then, you should stand still with a burning candle. Just like in the lab, you should pull back any hair or secure loose clothes so you don't start a fire. Like what happened to you last Pascha.
Oh, it took so much hair. You should also be mindful of any liquids you might have in church. Being Orthodox, we use water and wine frequently in our services, and we want to avoid any spills. You wouldn't want a priest or a deacon to slip while sensing the church.
If they fell, the charcoal in the censer could start a fire.
And we already talked about how dangerous fire can be.
The next set of rules we need to go over are rules of respect.
When we enter church, we enter the throne room of God. There we commune with Him, all His angels, and all of His saints. That requires respect and reverence.
Which means no food or drink in church, especially if you plan on receiving communion. When going up for communion, there should be no food or gum in your mouth.
The same goes for venerating icons. Icons are windows into heaven. You should always be respectful when you approach them. That means no food, gum, or lipstick should be in or on your mouth when you venerate them.
Speaking of being respectful, we can respect others during church by being quiet. There's plenty of time during coffee hour to talk to friends. Being quiet allows us all to focus on being present with God.
Another thing you can do is to record and share your knowledge. Pay attention to the gospel and epistle readings. Take note of the saints we commemorate each Sunday. You can keep track of all of this in a church journal, just like you would a lab notebook or an adventure journal.
That sounds like a great idea. I'm excited to try it out today.
Well, thanks for learning about so many different rules with us today, Orthodox Explorers.
And thanks for following them. Hopefully you can use them outside, in the lab, and in church.
We hope you join us next time so we can continue digging into science
and digging into our faith.
Bye!